What's up, my people? Welcome back to another beautiful Saturday. It's the first Saturday of the month of May, and I'm super excited. By the way, my name is Ibi Douglas, and I'm a brand and visual identity designer. If you are new to this channel, you are highly welcome. Do well to hit that subscribe button and turn on the post notification bell so you'll be among the first people to be updated when new videos like this drops. All right, so let's just get straight to it. So this design was inspired by this, so you could see some similarities, I guess. And this design was done by the creative abstract design genius himself, goes by the name Nana Multimillionaire, aka Nana Multimedia. Spoken about him in my previous videos. Do well to check him out on Instagram and YouTube. He's a fantastic designer and is one person you should definitely, you know, check out and get inspiration and learn from. Yeah, I guess without further ado, let's just get straight to it. So I'm going to be turning off my second artboard, and then we're going to focus on this guy. Turn off everything here. Cool. So started from my color. Now my background colors are inspired by the colors from the images itself. Either I pick the color from the image, or I use a color that complements the color from the image for my background. So that's what I always do. So this is like a kind of creamy color. Yeah. The next thing I added was the image. By the way, you should actually check out this creative designer. His name is Shegs. Full name, Godwin Awaji Iroso Abiodun. We all call him Shegs as close friends. So check him out on Facebook. Check him out on IG. He's a super fantastic designer and model. So yeah, I converted this image to black and white first, which, you know, most of you guys are already aware of. If you want to convert an image to black and white, simply just hit your shift control alternate and all, everything just converts to black and white. Yeah, so that was what I did. Converted the image to black and white before I imported it to my design, and then I applied the blend mode for soft light and reduced the opacity to 57%. This wasn't the focus of the design, so that's why I reduced it a little bit. So I just fused it in the background. The next thing I added was this pattern. Now I got this pattern from Pinterest. You see African pattern, just search on Pinterest. You see on for African patterns, you see so many patterns. If I double click this, because I had to convert it to a smart object, it's actually white, right? And then I did like a color overlay where I picked this blue color from the image itself, gave it that effect, and then yeah, I did that. But whilst also, when I finished, I was like, okay, let me do something different to this pattern. And then I went to my blend mode and I added this dissolve effect. So if I take it, if you look at it in this form, this is how it is normally. But you see that adding that dissolve mode gave it this kind of different, you know, glass-like kind of feel. So that was what I did for that. And then the next thing I did was to add like my write-up. That was like the write-up I generated from ChatGPT, duplicated it and all. Then I added my image. Yep, added my image. And then I did like a gradient overlay on top of it, where I was going to add like the text and another image at the top. So this is like the gradient overlay. So I picked this from the image, actually, like I said, just increased my saturation a bit, the blue, you know. And then the next thing I did again was to add this pattern, but this time I added this pattern just here. The reason why it's not going to cover it here is because there is actually an image which I'm going to see. So I just focused it here because of what I was going to put here. I didn't bother doing that. So add my text, the name of this font, actually, this is like the initials of the celebrant's name. GAIA. So if I want to show, let me just show you guys the name of the font so we could see. So Spotlight, I believe, is the name of the font. Spotlight. Check it out on this. I actually mixed two fonts to do this. This other one is Racing Sports Display. So let me explain why I did what I did. Okay, if I wanted to have used the Spotlight and I added this G, this is the G for the Spotlight. So it looked like number six. I tried, and it wasn't really giving me what I wanted, but I wanted to use the font actually. So I started checking out my font bank, and I was like, okay, what other fonts can I use that could, go well with this? And then I checked and checked and checked, and I discovered this font, which is sorry, let's go back to. So I checked and checked and discovered this one, right, which is Racing Sports Display. I figured that it's a little bit similar to this other font that I'm using here, which is Spotlight. So you could download both of them from thatfont.com, or you could just search it on Google. Racing Sport Display and Spotlight. So that was what I did for the letter G. And I think I did the same. Okay, my letter I and A was the same font. The only thing I changed here was letter G, so it could somehow like fit to what I was doing. So I did that, and then I added this GIA. This was like the same thing, but I now wrote everything horizontally, and then I just positioned it here, let it like look like a pattern and all that. Added the stroke effect. So if you want to add the stroke effect for this, right, first and foremost, this is how the stuff was. It was white, and so I had to add my stroke first. So just go to options here, go to your blending options. That's your right click on the layer, go to blending options, and you go to stroke. So in this stroke, you just pick it here and pick the color from your swatch or from your background, and increase. So yeah, make sure your preview is on. And then I selected inside, and then I increased it to 5. So the reason why you won't be seeing it is because I turned off the effect actually, right? So I just did that, and then I reduced my fill to 0. So it had removed the fill, the white fill, and it just left only the stroke. Okay, so another thing, added shags here. This name of this font is Black Signature. Gave it the creamish color, so goes by the name Shags. We all know him as Shags, formally and informally. So, and then the next thing I added was like my date, the birthday date, just to balance up this section here. I know you guys were like, what's here? What is it? What is it? Don't worry, relax. Double the hot, calm down. And then added happy birthday text here. Name of the font I used here was Rockwell. So you might be like, today you tried different fonts. So yeah, I was testing some things, but you won't really notice, sure. But I didn't want to go overboard. But I was just testing some fonts. But I didn't go. I think what I just used maximum here was like three fonts, I think. I believe so. And then yeah, the picture you guys have actually been waiting for. Yes, I added this picture. So this is why you could see why I didn't put any pattern here. There was going to be a picture here actually. Added this picture, and then the name, just so you could see how the name just was fitted at the back, or position at the back of the image, the pattern position at the back of the image, the right top position at the back of the image, that kind of thing. Yeah, so added that, and then I added the full name of GAIA. So I can't make that assumption that everybody knows what GAIA is. So I had to write the full name of the person, Godwin Awaji Russell Abiodun. Did that, and then the next thing I added was like this light effect. I did like Let me disable the layer mask so you would actually see how this background is. Let's remove it from the screen mode. Yeah, so this is the image actually. So if you don't know, you don't know. So this is the light effect, and because it's a dark background, right? Because it's a dark background, if you just go straight to screen mode, this is how it's gonna look, right? This is how it's gonna look. Once you just, as far as I'm using a dark background image, right? Once you take it to the screen mode, it's gonna remove all the dark black solid colors and all that. It's gonna give you like what's gonna be there, the other elements that are not black. So that's how I was able to achieve this. And I the reason why I added this was because of the position of this image where he was looking at. So it looked like as if this was like sun rays, that kind of thing, that is like, you know, he's looking at it and it's like it's reflecting on him, that kind of thing. So that was why I added that, and then, you know, I created that effect, right? And then I used my brush tool to brush off some areas. Right, I used my brush to brush off some areas. That was after when I applied my layer mask. So applied, if I enable this, I brushed off some areas that I didn't want on the design. Yeah, so that's basically it. Let's put this back here. And then I just added my logo at this point here. Then did my finishing touches, converted everything to one image, like I've always seen. You want to convert all your layers to one image, just hold your Shift Control Alternate E, and then it converts all layers to one image. And then you can, before you take it to your camera roll to add the crispiness and the effect and all that, make sure you convert it to Smart Object. So right click and convert to Smart Object, and then I go to my camera roll, Shift Control A. So in my camera raw section here, I just always play with some certain things. I always make sure I add my noise, which I'll call green. If we zoom this, you could actually see this. So this is personal preference. You can choose to however you want to add it, but I always try to make sure mine is not really that much. Zooming it out a bit. Just gonna add just little clarity. Sometimes I might add, like, you know, just play around with this guy. There is no one size fits all, one pattern or one preference, you know. So that's what I did here. I'm just gonna click no because I'd already created this. So this is my image and this is it. So you might be asking, why do you always add your use camera raw on my designs? I do that to amplify my design itself. So I might want to add some effects. I might want to also make some things a little bit crispy and, you know, more like, you know, make the design a little bit more crispy than it is. So I always go to my camera roll once I'm done with my design to like apply the finishing touches and everything. All right, so that is it. I'm gonna delete this layer, it's not needed. And then I duplicated my layer for artboard 2, and nothing really much on artboard 2, but just, you know, few things. Almost everything here is a little bit the same, but yeah, let's just break it down. Okay, so this time went for the color blue instead of the color peach. The image, still added this image, but I moved the image to the left hand side. I'm just trying something totally different. Same thing, color overlay. The color is actually blue, just like what I used there, but then I added a color overlay to change this. So I just like inverted the colors from what I did from this first one. I just inverted it here. So same thing, but I still used the dissolve blend mode. If I take this normal, this is how it is. If I use the dissolve blend mode, you could see this. And then this image, this is actually the image from this. So you've watched my previous videos, you would see how I was able to achieve this. By the way, if you've actually not watched my previous poster design breakdowns, do well to check the link in the description below to catch up with those videos, and you might also see it displaying here on your screen. How I was able to achieve this, super simple. I'm just gonna do a quick one for you guys. Let's add this image here. Let's add this image here. I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna make a duplicate of it. I'm gonna make a duplicate of this image. So we'll just do this. So this is my image, right? And what I'll just do is to right click, I go to my blending options and then I come to color overlay, right? Just come to color overlay, simple. I used, because this was the previous thing I used for something. Let us go straight to it. Pick the color here, simple, voila. This is just all you need to do. And then you placed it wherever you want to, you know? So that's just how to achieve that effect, okay? So just did that and then I positioned it here, not minding, definitely there's going to be an image to cover this. So that's why I just positioned it the way it is. And next thing, still added the right top, this position, added this stuff. I just shifted it from here, shifted it to this place, inverted the color to the peach color. And then I added my image. I'm going to remove this color overlay. Yeah, that was a mistake. I think that was when I was showing you guys the stuff I did. So image was added here. Oh, sorry guys, let's delete this. That was this thing. So let's put back this image I added. And then I added like a gradient overlay, sort of cover this area because I was going to add some things in it. I then now included the pattern itself, the same pattern that was used there. That's the same pattern here. Use like a luminosity effect when I click mark. So if I remove this, this is actually like the pattern entirely. So I just wanted it on this. So you hold your alternate key to click mask and then it goes in there. And then I just, same thing here, just brought it here and then I rotate it, right? Change the color to blue. And then the light effect was still here. Same effect I added on the previous one. And then my right top and the full name of GAIA. So added it in this position. Added my date and just added the logo bit here. Yeah, finished everything. Very simple. Just inverted some things and then added my camera raw effect to give me this. So yeah, pretty much. Very simple but creative. So we have come to the end of this video. If you actually enjoyed this tutorial, do well to drop a comment below. Do not forget to like. Do not forget to also hit that share button so a designer could watch and also be inspired by this video. Recently, I got a feedback from the previous video I made of a request from one of us. Saying, oh, I should actually share these elements that I use in my design so they could also practice along. And that request, I took note of that and I would like to say your request has been granted. So because of that, the elements I used for this design and the previous poster design I made last week Saturday will be dropped in the link in the description below. So do well to check it out. It's going to be in a Google Drive, or it's in a Google Drive. You have access to all the elements, both the fonts and the elements that were used, not the images actually, just the elements, the fonts that were used, the pattern that was used, and then any other element that was used in the design, both in the previous poster design, which was a relationship poster design, and then also this tutorial as well. So every element, you're going to see it there. Use that to practice along with these videos that you have watched. All right, and lastly, do not forget to hit that subscribe button as well so you could catch up with future videos. All right guys, thank you so much and see you next Saturday. Peace.